In this lesson, we are going to learn how to use this infrared obstacle avoidance from SunFounder with this ESP32 module and ESP32 extension camera extension module to detect an obstacle. I've also added a buzzer here. When I bring my hand, it detects the obstacle, it turns on, and when there is nothing, it's off. We can see it also on the screen. ESP32 starter kit from SunFounder. This is the best ESP32 learning kit from SunFounder. It has this ESP32 microcontroller, which has built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. This board can do everything Arduino Uno can do or many other Arduinos can do, plus extra more features. Because we have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, the possibilities are endless. You can get connected to the cloud or do the control or read information or values via your mobile device or your desktop or over the cloud from a far location. It comes with a camera extension kit where you can stream the video over Wi-Fi either through the cloud or to your network. And also it comes with micro SD card where you can save images on the micro SD card, or you can write from the device any information, log the information on the device and read it back. You can power the board using this included 18650 lithium battery, and it has built-in charger where you can connect micro USB and charge the battery. The kit comes with 320 pieces of component that you can learn tons of projects. Come to this page, docs.sunfounder.com. Scroll down until you see ESP32. Then click on ESP32 Starter Kit Main. On the left side, click on Arduino User. After that, scroll down and click on 5.3, Detect Obstacle. This is the documentation page for our today's lesson. So we are going to use the infrared obstacle avoidance module. For this lesson, we need our ESP32 module, ESP32 camera extension, jumper wire, and obstacle avoidance module. If I click on this, here we have explanation for this. One pin is labeled as VCC. We will connect it to 3.3 volts or 5 volts. It will work fine. And then the ground is connected to the ground. And then out pin is the signal pin, which usually is high level. And when it goes low, when the obstacle is detected. There is also two lights. One light is for the power. The other light is when the obstacle is detected. Actually, this one has two infrared, one transmitter, one receiver, and this is just operational amplifier. There is a potentiometer where we can set the sensitivity. So how it works is that one is the transmitter. It transmits infrared. It transmits infrared ray like that. And if there is an obstacle or a surface, it reflects back. And the other one is photodiode or infrared receiver. It receives the reflection and is being amplified by the operational amplifier, and we can detect and use it for our purpose. So we know there is something. If there is nothing, the ray goes, it does not reflect back. And the pins that are available are these pins. Again, there is a schematic for the wiring. We will connect it to the out pin, will be connected to pin 14. And then VCC will connect it to 3.3 volts and ground will be to the ground, which I'm going to show you. Here is actual wiring. And we have a simple Arduino code, which I'm going to explain it fully. And here for this lesson, we just need male to female wires. I'm just gonna connect it. So the green is the output. Doesn't matter which color you connect. So this is now connected. and output will be connected, as we mentioned here, to pin 14. Let's connect output. In this case, I have green. It will be connected. Hold the board such that USB is on this side. Pin 14 is the fifth pin from the left. And then the middle pin, the middle is ground. I'm connecting it to the second pin. And the last pin is VCC. We can connect it to 5 volts here or 3.3 volts. Let's connect it to 5 volts because it's closer. And the wiring is now completed. I'm opening Arduino IDE. Let's open our project by clicking on File, Open. On the left side, click on Downloads, then ESP32 Starter Kit Main. On the right side, double click to open it, double click on C, double click on Codes, and click on 5.3 Avoid, double click and select 5.3 Avoid file and click Open. And this is our code. We are defining pin 14 for avoid pin, which is type of integer and constant, so this cannot change. And this avoid state is a variable that is holding the state of the sensor. Inside the setup, we run only these two lines, which runs only once. Using serial.begin, we are defining serial monitor with 115,200. And then we are using pin mode and that pin that we defined in here, pin 14, as input. That's done. Inside the loop, we use digital read and we pass the pin to it. So we are reading the output from the sensor, and the result of this sensing will be stored in a variable called avoid state. And then we use serial.println to print this value, either 0 or 1 on the screen. And the loop will continuously do the same thing over and over again. Now let's see how we can select the ESP32 board. We can click here under the select board and type here ESP32DEV. As soon as you type dev, you will see dev board. You can select it and click OK. So the board has been selected. Now we have to select the port. The other way to select the board is click on Tools, Board, ESP32, and select the ESP32 dev module. Now we have to select the port. If I click here, it shows two ports, and I don't know which one belongs to my device. Sometimes you will not see the number properly. So the best way to be sure, right click on the start menu, go to the device manager, and you will see here the ports. If I click on this arrow, it will show me the ports. One is USB serial CH340, the other is USB serial device. And here, now it's connected. If I disconnect this, one of them disappears. The one that disappeared is my board. So 6 stays and 8 disappeared. If I connect it, so 8 is my COM port, CH340. Now 8 is my COM port and I can select it. Or I can click on Tool, Port, and here you will see it. You can select whichever you want. Ours is COM8. Now we have successfully selected the board and the port. And this is very important. It must be done first. And now let's upload the code. The port, everything has been selected with USB. The code has been uploaded successfully, but we have to open the serial monitor. Click here, and as you can see, we are reading 1. If you cannot read the value, make sure that this is 115,200. The value that is here must match. For example, if you have 9,600, you will not be able to read. You will read something like this. So make sure it matches with the value that you typed here. So we are reading now 1. And here, as you can see, this light is on and this light is off, and we have no obstacle, meaning that this ray is going and it's not coming back. If I have some obstacle or something in front of it that it can reflect, as you can see, we read 0 and remove it, it is 1. And also pay attention that the light will turn on. Now, let's see how far this can work. Now let's see if we can measure and see how far we can detect. I put this box from SunFounder's, and there is a ruler exactly attached so you can see it. And I'm placing this and pay attention to the light and read this in centimeter. So as you can see, it's around 7 if you look at this portion. If not, it's 8. So it's around 8, and then it will turn off. So at 8 centimeter, we are detecting this obstacle here. So this obstacle, exactly at 8. Now let's see if we can increase it. So what we do is I'm going to point it to the air, and as you can see, the light is off. We are turning this clockwise until we read, until this light is barely on. So let's go clockwise. I'm going slowly. Yes, so now barely it. As I brought it just turned on. Now this is, so when it turned on, then just go a little, so it's off. Now it's very sensitive, and as you can see, we have increased it to 13 centimeters. So before it was around 8, now it's around 13. You can see if you count this line, even 14. Yeah, 13 centimeter. So this way you can adjust the sensitivity. If you want to make it a little fancier, you could do so like this. So if there is something, you can say obstacle. For example, we can say F and bring this variable here. Because we said 1 means true. We say if it is true, then here let's put this and then say serial dot print in LN. We say nothing else. We can print a text instead of that. We say obstacle. So this is now much better because we know it will work. Let me upload the code to the board. It is shown now at the bottom. And if I point it to the empty space, we are reading nothing, and then if I bring it to the obstacle, because it sees the obstacle, it says obstacle, and then nothing. This is much better. And here, if you want to know the amount of current from ESP32, this is a data sheet for ESP32. So when you set the current for 3.3 volts, when you set it to high, the maximum, the typical is 40 milliampere. So that's huge amount of current. This is when it is high. If you want to set it to low, then it will be maximum at 28 milliampere. Now I'm going to show you the amount of current that this buzzer needs. I've connected it to 3.3 volts. First, let me show you the voltage. This is negative and that's a positive. So let's see the voltage first. 3.28 volts. So that's 3.3 volts. I'm connecting the negative to the negative and then this positive to the buzzer. And let's read the current. So it's around 15 milliampere. And it is safe to use it with ESP32 to turn it on from the pins. If we have only one of this, it will be okay. There is no harm for ESP32 to turn the buzzer on because we measured it and it is around 16 milliampere. I've connected the negative to the negative and the positive of this active buzzer to the pin 27 here, just beside the obstacle avoidance. And first, let's define this pin 27 as an output inside the setup. And then below this line, we write digital write 27 low. When there is nothing, it should be low. And else mean if there is something, there is an obstacle, we say digital write 27 high. Let's upload the code. And here the light is off. The buzzer is already connected to pin 27. So completed. Let me push this up. There is nothing. So when there is an obstacle, it buzzes. Perfect.